Welcome to the Florida Southwestern College Lee campus in Fort Myers, Florida.
Today we're visiting the exhibition Guerrilla Girls, Rattling Cages Since 1985, held at Bob Rauschenberg Gallery at FSW. The first thing that catches the eye at the exhibition is the abundance of yellow and red posters with the brand name and gorilla masks. Walking through the exposition, you find nothing but placards with dry facts about gender and racial parity in the art world. Facts diluted here and there by some nude female pictures, statements of some famous people, or sarcastic inserts. Two questions appear instantly. Where did the name Guerrilla Girls come from, and why do they wear gorilla masks? What is the connection?
It all started in 1985 when the Museum of Modern Art in New York opened an exhibition titled An International Survey of Painting and Sculpture. It was supposed to be a summary of the most significant contemporary art in the world. Out of 169 artists, only 13 were women. All the artists were white. That was bad enough, but the curator said any artist who is not in the show should rethink his career. Guerrilla Girls is an anonymous group of feminist artists devoted to fighting sexism and racism within the art world. The movement formed with the mission of bringing gender and racial inequality into focus within the art community. They use names of dead women artists to reinforce their presence in history and to solve today's members' interview problems. Although calling a grown woman a girl can imply that she is not mature or grown up, they decided to reclaim the word girl in their movement name so it could not be used against them. The word gorilla came with the desire to play with the fear of guerrilla warfare, to make people afraid of who they might be and where they would strike next.
Why did you choose gorilla? Is it because is it dehumanizing or because they're scary?
Well, first we were Gettys, you know, freedom fighters, gorillas, and then we got some press requests and we wanted to have our pictures, but we were anonymous, we wanted to hide ourselves. So one of our early members was a really bad speller. And we were sitting at a meeting one day and she spelled Guerrilla gorilla, and it was like, wow. That's it.
Oh, so originally it was gorilla, like gorilla fighter.
Guerrilla.
And then she misspelled it like the animal?
Absolutely. Yeah.
And you just went with it?
Well, it was a message from heaven. If someone had said to me 30 years ago you'd still be doing this, I would have told them they were absolutely crazy.
I've just been doing it for so long. Sometimes I forget I have a mask on.
We're a bunch of anonymous women artists who started complaining about the art world in 1985, and we did it with posters on the streets of New York. We take the names of dead women artists to keep their memories alive.
Their identities are secret, but their message is clear. End inequality in the art world.
It is 30 years since the Guerrilla Girls came into being. A lot has changed and a lot has not. The Whitney Museum says, "Isn't it wonderful? We have 30% women in the new collection." The activist known as Frida Kahlo of Guerrilla Girls movement added, "Why is that something to be happy about? 30%? Where's the other 20?"